Crate Raiderz, man. We raid crates.
See, the crazy thing is, I saw your villain. It's the way thing that it take to do the killing. Born and raised in a project building. I was born and raised in a project. But the amazing thing is, my face to the ceiling. Praying that God would use me to save millions. Born and raised in a project building. I was born and raised in a project. I would like to say salute to the soldiers. Those getting loot but staying true to their culture. Fill my hat to you like a lieutenant supposed to the scripture. So lethal had to throw it in the holster.
1-2-1-2, check it out. DJ Jimmy Cut, my man Sammy Cook. DJ All Hands.
That's right, All Hands in the building, yo. Crate Raiderz crew, y'all know what it is. Y'all know what we here to do. Not gonna tell you where we are. I will tell you we in Germantown, you know what I'm saying? I'm not gonna tell you who crib this is, not until we knock on the door and he answers, then you will know. But I will tell you that behind this door is some joints. Behind this door, some gems. Behind this door, some crates. You know what I mean?
So let's time to raid the crates.
Let's raid the crates, man. Knock on the door. So you can see who crib this is. Yeah, that's right. Street in the building, right? You know what I mean? Here to raid the crates, man.
No doubt.
All right, let's go.
Oh. Yeah, man, it's working everywhere.
Oh my. What's the
deal? Oh, it's going down up in here. Yes.
Oh,
man.
Like heaven up in this joint.
Yo, it's joints everywhere. So you got the sound. Oh my God. Yeah. I'm looking around, man. It's crazy. Introduce yourself to the people real quick, man, so we can get it started.
Dre, Street Orchestra Productions. Sparrow, one half of Sparrow, the group Sparrow. That's about it. You know what I mean?
Alright, man. I'm looking around. Every time I go to somebody's crib and we digging, they say you gotta check out street shit. So, you know, we here, raiding crates, you know what I mean? Crate Raiderz crew. DJ All Hands, DJ Ken Cut, Sammy Cook, my man Jazz, aka Cup of Sice, behind the camera. So I'm looking around, man, and it's crazy.
Unbelievable, dude.
Yo, so how long you been digging? Or how long you been collecting? Let's go there.
Like, seriously collecting like 96.
96?
Yeah, like 96, 97. You know, that rap about that. But I was just buying. I didn't even know what I was getting.
Okay.
I was just buying records. Like, just go to thrift store, buy like 25, 30 records you don't know.
Right.
You know what I mean? But yeah. Then later on, you start knowing. I started knowing I was getting by like 2000, 2001.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Start knowing like, all right, this is what this is. You know?
So out of all these records, you know what I mean, you come up on most of them in the thrift store or?
Anywhere. Thrift store. People, houses, trash.
Right.
You know what I mean? Store. Yeah, anywhere. Uh-huh. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Anywhere. All right, man. We're going to take a look at the collection, right? But we also care, you know, to check out what you as a collector consider your top three records, your top three pieces.
Okay.
Now, I'm looking around on the wall, man, and to pick like three out of all this, this is some like Honey and the Bees? Come on, yo. Man, that's like Northside.
Yeah, that's crazy.
You know what I'm saying?
That's a crazy record right there.
Yo,
I got that one for like a buck, man. I didn't know what it was. I just grabbed it, and then when I got it, I was like,
let's see. Pick something out, Cut. Pick something out.
Oh, man, you know what I'm going to pick out? Fish That Served St. Pittsburgh soundtrack.
Oh, yeah.
How long you had that joint?
I got that in like 01. That's a promo.
A promo copy?
Yeah, it's a promo. Wow. Yeah, I got that in like 01. You know what I mean? Yeah. I like that. A lot of people used it, but I didn't know. Like, when I got it, I didn't know people used it. You know what I mean? I just got it, started messing with it. You know, I did a couple beats off of it. But, you know what I mean? But, you know, the more I listen to it, I'm like, damn, dude, use this, dude, use that. I'm like, okay, all right, that's what it is. But awesome soundtrack, though. Crazy.
Yeah. So when you come across these soundtracks, yeah. Do you take them home and listen to the whole thing, or do you just pick out one song or that you heard before?
Listen to the whole joint.
Yeah. So like, all these joints, you listen to the whole joint?
Yeah. You just put it on and you do other stuff in the house. Yeah. And you just hear it. You know what I mean?
Right.
You just can't effectively produce a record without listening to the whole record. All
right.
You know what I mean? So you got to listen to the whole record. And then you like, all right, that's what it is.
Wow.
You know what I mean?
What's this one right here? Maceo Us?
Oh yeah. It's an ill cut on there called Soul of a Black Man that I just love. Like every record up here is a song or two, if not more, that I just love a record. You see what I'm saying? Like some of them are rarer than others, but it's like this ain't that rare. It's about a $15-$20 record.
Right.
You know what I mean? It ain't that rare about it, but it's crazy. The Soul of a Black Man song is just out of here.
Right,
you know what I mean? It's just ridiculous.
All right, so let's get into your first piece then. What's your first piece, man? Pull out the first piece, man.
All right, first piece, I got to say this one, man.
All
right. This our record. This right here. I'm going to duplicate it for me. This right here. That's the record me and my boy did. Yeah, we did that record in 95.
Okay. So this is a personal record?
Yeah, it's a personal record. All three of these is my personal records.
Okay.
We put out all four. We did, that's the first one in 95. That one in 98/99,
okay,
2000, and then we just put that reissue out, the release out last year.
Okay.
So all of those is that right there. That record right there,
your
the first one, came out like 95, then it took off. This dude, DJ JRU and Overseas played it. People start digging for it. Now that record ranged from anywhere from $200 to $1,500.
Wow.
It's like, all right, let me explain. So my house is more so set up like I'm shopping.
Right.
So it's like, I might not know where everything is, so when I'm digging for stuff, it's like I'm in the store.
Gotcha.
So when I'm finding stuff, I'm like, oh damn, that's what that is, and then I pick it up, then I use it.
Right.
So it's, everything is fresh for me.
Right.
Rather than knowing this, that, and that. Of course, you know what certain things are.
Right.
But like, the way I got it set up, like, I might go through here, like, damn, I didn't know that was right there. Then I go use it.
Right.
So it's like a store.
Right.
It's my stuff, but it's a store.
And I'm looking at all the stuff in here, man.
Yeah,
you got pieces, man.
Yeah, man.
It's probably like incredible to know where everything is at all times.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
Let's go over here to this wall over here. Tell me about this Johnny Jenkins.
Oh yeah. A real ill drum break on that record.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. It's like it go on for a long time. Probably about 16 bars. It's crazy to start off like that. It's just real ill. It's like a blues record. It's more stuff on there. Everybody buy for the drums, but there's some blues songs on that. It's nice.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like real nice soulish blues type of album. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like real. It's a real record. All
right. So I see you got anything up on the walls and
everything. It's black.
Yeah. So do you pull them down? Can we pull down that one and check it out?
Whiskey. Lord, me blues made me sloppy drunk.
So when you got this, had you heard about it before? Had you heard it before? You just no.
Just
stumbled across.
I just got it.
Yeah.
I got that when I was still living in Baltimore. Okay. You know, see, I got this when I was home.
So you had that for?
I had this for a couple of years. Okay. You know what I mean? But I ain't seen it since I got it. You know what I mean? So
yeah.
It's like, but I know it's out there. I know it ain't super, super rare.
Okay.
About $40.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
you
yeah.
know, nice little piece of change or whatever
right.
like that. But no, I ain't know about it. I just got it. You know, because dude looked like.
Yeah, from the cover, right?
He looked like Gator. You know
right,
what I mean?
Right.
Off of Truck Turner.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Exactly.
Dude was chasing, you know what I mean? He looked like Gator. So it's like, seen Truck Turner already, so I was laughing. I said, dude, look like Gator. You know what I mean? So I just picked it up, you know, and I was like, okay. And then, you know, I was like, yo, it's pretty hot.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So,
do you find a lot of joints from just the cover?
I try not to. I read records.
Okay.
You know what I mean? You might read players. You might say, this dude played the horn on this album, or this dude played the drums on this, or this
okay.
and that. Like, sometimes, you know, covers is deceiving.
Right.
You know what I mean? You might have a hot cover, like it ass.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, you know, it's. But, you know, sometimes, you know what I mean? You do look at covers. You know what I mean? Like, it's like, you know, like, who wouldn't buy this?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? What I'm saying? You know what I mean? Like who wouldn't buy that? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's like, you know, you look at covers and like, okay, alright, that's cool. But you know, but you more so, the more you dig, the more you know about rappers and the more
Session
you
players.
More, yeah, exactly. You look at that, you look at the years it was recorded, you look at down to the studios it was recorded in.
So let's get into your second piece. You
okay.
know what I mean? We're gonna get into the second piece. What's
okay.
your second piece?
This is my second piece here, man. Definitely not rare at all.
Ooh.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Wow.
Right here,
yes.
Damn. Right here. It's right here.
Yes.
Needed to
Yo.
Groove. This
Come
is the second
on,
piece
man.
Right here. This,
Come
this right
on,
here,
man.
This right here, I bought this when it came out.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Of course.
It's still messed up. I got this when it came out, man.
Yo.
But this
man.
Right here, I heard this record on the radio
okay.
when it came out back in the day, and this is the first record that I heard that made me want to do beats. You
man,
know what I'm saying? So it's like, when I heard, I always liked hip hop, but then when I heard Needle to the Groove, it was like, how did he do that? You know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
what? How did he do that?
Right.
And then it just triggered, then I wanted to make beats after I heard this record. You know, he was way before his time, man, and it's like when I heard that song, that and Fresh is the Word. When
okay.
I heard those two right there, it was just like, Fresh is the Word solidified it, but this right here is the one that made it.
So when you went and
you know
got this, you know what I mean? Did you probably had to search for it, because back then you
yeah,
had records store.
It's in the store.
Yeah,
right,
yeah.
Right.
But, all right, so you got it,
mm-hmm.
took it home, played it, scratched, mm-hmm. you know, got down on it, or was you cutting at that point?
I didn't have,
turntable?
I didn't have turntable, that was my dad's turntable.
Oh, okay.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, you know what I mean? I
with the 8-track on it?
Yeah, the yard, when you scratch and you turning the volume up,
yeah.
you going up, turn it down, move it back, turn it up, move
yeah.
you know, doing that type of stuff
exactly.
like that back then, you know, but that... That's the one right there. It's like, yo.
Let's hit a joint for the cats who don't, you know.
Oh, no, they need
yeah,
to
yeah.
groove.
Yeah, yeah, I'm saying.
Wow.
It's all
scratchy.
Yeah, yeah,
day,
but that's
man.
That. That's that good sound. Now. All people in the place to be. This is Mad Songs with MCT. The morning before all the winter brothers promoted. Giving you a sensation, so we made it to the point.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mantronics.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah,
that's the first time somebody pulled out Mantronics too.
Woo! Yeah, man.
Mantronics way ahead of his time, man.
Of course, man. Of course.
He like I put him in the same joint as Said G. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people when you mention producers won't mention Mantronics
mm-hmm.
and won't mention Said G,
mm-hmm.
but they created their own styles. Not
yes.
only their own styles,
mm-hmm.
but you know, their own sounds.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
So
it's like they took nothing and made something out of it. You know what I mean? So the same as Marley Marl took something, made nothing out of it. It's like, man, Tronix, man.
Yeah.
I just was into it. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. So, yeah.
Can we go through a couple of them and just pull out something real quick? Yeah. And have you tell somebody?
Yeah, see, I'm going to just reach in and grab something.
It's
like this one right there.
That's a Philly record.
Yeah, let's talk about it, man.
You got some of the stuff, man.
That's a funny record, man.
This is
recorded here, man.
Yeah.
It's pretty good. It's not crazy, but it's a record that got moments. Like, if you produce it, you can chop it up. You see what I'm saying? And then you can lay out however you want to lay it out. You know what I mean? It's a pretty good record. It's not a record that dudes is going to be like, yo, I need that.
Right.
You know what I mean? But it's a sleeper.
Okay.
What about something? You want to chill back and vibe.
It's a couple cuts on there like that. Some of them kind of fast, some of them kind of slow. But when you listen to it, you can tell it's definitely Philly International.
Oh, okay.
You can tell by the
That sounds good though.
It's good to make beats, you know what I'm saying?
I'll be in the morning, I wake up alone. In the evening, I make up a song.
That's when the record's gotta put work in. Yeah. It's like the sample, like right there for you.
Are you buying to listen?
Both.
To chop, to for value, you know what I'm saying?
All three. But like, if I'm going in a record store, I'ma go kind of type of mood, man.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I might have a crazy day at work. I just wanna buy something to listen to.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care if it got no samples on it. It's just something that I just want to zone out to.
Right.
You know what I mean? Sometimes you might come across stuff that I might got something on it. You're just like, yo, let me grab that. But it's like, you listen for all three. Sometimes you listen for, like, I'm not going to go out and just buy a super rare record.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to say this record.
Otherwise, you won't have nothing in your collection.
Absolutely. It's like, then all your records is rare records.
Right.
And it's like, you got no depth. Because all your joints is rare. It's nothing wrong with having rare records, a whole lot of them, but you need to have those Osley Brother records. You need to have all those other joints that, you know, that make up a collection. It's not like, it's sort of like eating Tasty Cakes all day. You know what I'm saying? with all the rare records, you know what I mean? You need to have your meats and vegetables. You need to have, you know what I mean? And those with the other records are.
Right.
You know what I mean? Those joints, you need those joints to make everything strong.
Right.
You know what
make
I mean?
Make a whole meal.
Absolutely.
Let me ask you this then. God forbid, it's a fire.
Oh, man.
God forbid, you know what I mean? I'm knocking wood and everything on that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Hey, no, look, we're not. We know it's a start all over again.
Right.
But what did you try to grab first?
Honestly,
yeah.
I would grab these crates right here.
Okay. They're the ones that you get busy with.
No, because I organized these. All these crates is drums.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So I know I can get my beats done. So it's like, all these are the drum records right here. Okay. Every record over here got a drum on it.
Okay, let's cut. Each of them just grab one.
Just grab one. Let's see what we got here.
Yeah.
You can tell the DJ. He pulls the record out so he knew it was. I just reach in.
Right.
Wow.
I'm saying, yeah. It's scattered drum breaks in there. You got kicks and snares or whatever like that. So, yeah, definitely. You know what I mean? So, yeah.
Yeah. Tell us about how long you had that.
That's like early in the game. You know, I had that record for about 9 years.
We didn't heard all the joints, man. Now, it's crazy in here. What I want to get into is like that third piece, man. The third piece.
Okay.
What is Dre's third piece ever in all this, man? Top joint, man.
What's going on?
What's going on?
Bob.
Yeah. Ooh. Okay.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? A lot of cats. Yeah. You know what I mean? You gonna pull him out?
Yeah, man, you know.
Okay. That's it right there. It's the
joint.
Man. What's going on?
Yeah, man. It's not a super rare record, but you know.
Right.
I love this record. You know what I mean?
So why is that like a special piece for you right there?
Because, man, like, it was a timeless record, man. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I think he did this record. He was like 32, 33 years old, something like that. Mm-hmm. And it's like the time frame when it came out. He just flipped everything. He was all clean cut. Now he like bearded out.
Right, right.
He changed his whole thing, started producing his own music.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? He finally started listing all the players inside of the record. This is the first record on Motown. He listed the players.
Oh, wow. Okay.
You know what I'm saying? You know, yeah.
Is this the joint that they didn't want to put out as is?
Yeah. Barry Gordy, he turned in, what would he turn in? I think he turned in What's Going On. Barry Gordy didn't want it.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Man. You know what that's mean? The classic piece right there, too.
Yeah. Yeah, he had to come back and just do the whole joint.
Time of the War and all that stuff. Yeah,
let's check out something from it. Let me see the cover real quick. What's going on? The dude got the young husky beard.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I mean? Got the trench on. Ooh. Exactly. Can't go wrong with that one.
It's like the whole album's a story. You just got to listen to it from beginning to end. You know what I mean? Like, it's a story. Start off with what's going on. You know what I mean? Then he go talking to his man. Then he leave him talking to his man. They get high. And after they get high, they start talking all conscious. You know, then they get spiritual.
Okay.
All on one side. It's like it goes into each other. You know what I mean? It's sort of like 30 minutes of somebody's time after you just got back from Vietnam. We don't need to escalate.
How long you had, you know what I mean, this record, or just been like laying around or whatever?
Yeah, my pop had it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That's your pop record?
Or? I don't know, man. It's probably one of the eight.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like, who knows?
Oh, you got eight of those?
Yeah.
Well, yeah. What's going on with that?
I just bought it.
Yeah?
Yeah. It's just one of those records. I'm still looking for a promo copy, though.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I want a promo. That's what I want, a promo. But, you know, when I see it, I just buy it.
Right.
And this is one of those records.
That's crazy right there.
You just can't have enough of that record.
Yeah, that's one of them joints you just lay back and vibe to, man, too, and listen to the whole thing all the way through.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. I think that's one reason why I love this record. It's like, before, it was like Barry Gordy this, Barry Gordy that.
Directing everything.
Exactly. Now, this is like, this is just Marvin. Like, this is him.
Right. Ain't no way in the world Barry Gordy would have let him take his pictures in the rain either.
That's what I'm saying. No, you know what I'm saying? No.
You know what I'm saying?
He got a collage in the inside of pictures. You know what I mean? It's like,
yeah.
It was like, that's just him. You know, it's sort of like he graduated on this album to, you know, to who he is. Not saying he wasn't a good,
right,
you know, musician, you know, because he was a drummer.
He came into his own.
You know what I'm saying? He just, you know, everybody got that album that solidified him, and I think this was the one. And it took him to that next level.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So that's why I love that record right there. It's like, it's a real good record.
Good third piece, man. Definitely a good third piece.